Most people that meet me and hear that I worked at SeaWorld ask me what I thought of the movie Blackfish, which was a documentary made about 10 years ago. And they're asking me because they want to know kind of if I thought SeaWorld was good to the whales. And they kind of are asking me because of the ant wild versus captivity argument. And so I'm going to bring a few points. I'm going to talk to you about a few points that you probably haven't thought of when you think of wild versus captive. And I get both sides of the argument. I really do. I get set them all free, and I get have some in captivity. And I can make arguments for both. And today I'm going to bring up some points that you probably haven't thought of. Okay, 4 points. The first point is most people don't really know how brutal the wild actually is. So when you're thinking about captivity has walls and boundaries and they're not free, you know what else has walls, or at least the boundaries? The wild. And when those boundaries are crossed, these animals can die a violent death. Okay? They have boundaries. Animals in the wild have a certain area, and they have that area for a reason. And when that's crossed into another animal zone, wolves, for example, it can be very, very, very bad and very painful. So don't think the wild's some boundaryless place, can captivity's this horrible walled area. The wild's brutal. You should watch a few things, okay, on your own. And you should see this with your own eyes. Okay, if you don't know that, you should watch what happens to chimps when they hunt other chimps and then cannibalize those chimps while they're still alive. You should see that with your own eyes. Okay, I'm not saying we shouldn't have chimps in the wild. Of course they should be in the wild. But don't think that the wild is some great place. It's a violent, violent place. Okay, you should watch when a male lion comes in and takes over a pride from the other male, comes and kills all the cubs of the females, so that he can then breed. You should watch when a wolf pack hunts buffalo and then slowly eats them alive for an hour. The buffalo's alive for an hour, just being eaten alive. It's bad. It's hard to watch. It should be hard to watch. But you can't kind of think in these terms of this thing's bad, captivity, and the wild is great. You need to look at the worst examples of what it's really like in most of the wild. Africa. Africa is a brutal place for animals. It's hard. It's really, really a brutal place on every single animal. Doesn't mean they shouldn't be there. Absolutely. But does that mean that we don't take any animals in captivity because we think that the wild's some great place? So think about that. Animals can be fairly, here's the other point, can be fairly happy in captivity if they are mentally and physically stimulated to some degree that they are in the wild. So that's where a lot of places, captivity places, get it wrong. Zoos being one of them. They're not physically stimulated very much. Bears, elephants, in the wild, they will walk hundreds of miles. And then they get to captivity and they just kind of sit where the food comes in. They're gonna not be right in the head. Elephants get foot problems when they stand there. So finally, zoos started to do things. I was at a zoo as a volunteer, and a bunch of volunteers stood around the areas and they threw apples. So the elephant would just walk laps to get them exercise, okay? That's the kind of stuff that has to happen for the animal to be even close to as happy as they are in the wild. And it's some animals, it's impossible to simulate. You just can't get them the same exercise and mental stimulation that they would in the wild. Some animals do actually pretty good in captivity because all they want to do is lay around all day, okay? So you have to try to simulate their exercise and their mental, what goes on mentally, because they need that, because they really haven't changed that much. They're still wild animals in a captive environment. They still have all the needs that they would in the wild. But animals in the wild, they, like I said, they have this range. Wolves will patrol hundreds of miles, okay? They have this large range. So when they get in captivity, you have to fill that need, because they still have that need. Even though it's a small area, they have this need to kind of patrol and to walk and to run and to be stimulated and to mark. You have to fulfill that. And if you can do that, and that's where SeaWorld gets it right. They mentally and physically stimulate their animals all day long. And that's where other places don't get it right. Another point is that isn't thought of is the animals can bring joy to people. There's only rich people can go on safari, for the most part. It's very expensive. I've never done one. Only rich people can go up to Puget Sound and see killer whales, okay? Animals can bring joy to people. I'll never forget the first show at SeaWorld ever. It was my first day ever. I'd never even seen a show before I started working at SeaWorld. And they sent me to the sound booth to watch the show because my first day, there was nothing for me to do during the show. And I remember the whale came out and he splashed the whole bottom 10 rows all around the pool. I have never to this day seen children that happy as those thousands of kids that got splashed. All I remember is it was arms and jumping up and down and screaming. It was the happiest I've ever seen some giant group of kids. It was amazing. And it was that day I said, this brings them a tremendous amount of joy. And that's important. It's not just, oh, those animals are sad. Maybe they're sad. Maybe they're not, right? Remember my other points. Maybe they're not that sad. I know who's happy, those kids, okay? And that's important. It's important. People are important too. And my last point, animal rights activists don't love animals. They hate people. And those are two very different things. Loving animals is one thing, hating people is another. So everything that kind of comes out of the movement isn't really about animals. It's really about disliking people. So that changes things. So there's a comment that I had. I did this whale video a couple months ago and almost everyone liked it. A lot of likes, a few dislikes, but one of the comments had 9 likes. And that was, the next comment had 5 likes, 4 likes. This comment had 9 likes, the most of any comment I had. And here's what it said. Keeping killer whales in captivity for money is like pimp running 13-year-old girls. No, it's not. It's nothing like that. Any adult with kids knows it is nothing like that. That is a horrible, horrible thing. It's not like that. So this person hates 13-year-old girls if he or she thinks that it's the same thing, because it's not. That's a horrible, horrible, evil thing. And keeping killer whales it says killer whales in captivity is like that. No, it's not. I've been with these killer whales in captivity. But for the most part, happy animals. There's things that could be done better, absolutely. But it's not the same. So think for yourself. Don't just listen to the talk. Don't just see these posts on social media and go, oh yeah, SeaWorld's bad. Because I saw this documentary and my friend said that these whales, it's like being in a bathtub for a human. No, it's not. I told you why it's not, okay? Think for yourself.